Hi. Today, your objective is to identify and complete number patterns. So sometimes number patterns are pretty easy to find whenever it's just simple skip counting. On this example, our numbers are 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10. Whenever we're looking at these numbers, we can see that the numbers are increasing. That means that something is being added. If we are skip counting by 2, that means that we are adding 2 each time. So if I wanted to complete this pattern, I would add 2 to 10, and then I would get 12. I could add 2 to 12, and then I would get 14. On this next pattern, we have 2 digits. When we look in the ones digit, we see that it's not changing. So we don't need to worry about the ones digit. The tens digit is changing each time. We also know that the number is decreasing, which means that we are subtracting something each time. 7 tens, 6 tens, I'm getting rid of 1 ten, which means I'm getting rid of a value of 10 each time. So if I wanted to find the next number in my pattern, I would subtract 10 and I would get 25. On this pattern, we have 3 digits. The ones place is not changing. The tens place is not changing. The hundreds place is changing. 300s, 400s, 500s, 600s, this number is increasing each time. And this number is increasing by 100. I have 300s and now I have 400s. That means I have a difference of 100s. So to continue my pattern, I will add 100 and I will get 787. So, what are some important rules to keep in mind whenever we are finding a number pattern? 1. Look at the digits. Which digits are changing? After I look at which digits are changing, I need to decide, is my number increasing or decreasing? Increasing would mean we're adding, decreasing would mean we're subtracting. And then finally, by how much? By how much is my number increasing or decreasing? So let's think about these rules using this number pattern. Before I decide if I need to use my place value chart, I could try taking a look at just my numbers. If I look in the ones place, I see my number is not changing in the ones place. In the tens place, my number is also not changing. But in the hundreds place, I notice a change, and also we're going to pretend this number doesn't exist. There's a change happening in my 100s place. Is my number increasing or decreasing? I have a 6, and then I have a 4, and then I have a 2. My number is decreasing. And by how much is it decreasing? So here, I may be able to find out that my number is decreasing by 200 just by looking. However, it might help to put these numbers into a place value chart. $686, $486, $286. I already know that I don't have to worry about my ones or my tens because those digits are not changing, but here in the hundreds, I can see 600, 400, that means that this digit is changing by 2. 4 to 2, this digit is changing by 2. However, since this 2 is in the hundreds place, that means it's actually changing by 200. So my number pattern is decreasing by 200. That's the rule for this pattern, a decrease of 200. Let's take a look at another one. Here's a place value chart, just in case I need it. First, I look at which digits are changing. My 1s are not changing. My 10s are not changing. My 100s are not changing, and neither are my 1000s. My 10,000s are not changing. I don't need to worry about any of these digits. My rule is only changing the 100,000s place of this number. So is my number increasing or decreasing? I have 200,000, 300,000, 400,000. My number pattern is increasing each time. So I have a 200,000 and a 300,000. I may be able to tell already what my pattern is, but I'm going to write it in this place value chart just to confirm. So my first number is 2nd number, and 3rd number. Okay, so I already know I don't need to worry about any of these places because this digit is not changing. 2, 3, 4. Oh, I see it here. +1, +1. Since this 1 is in the 100,000s place, that means that my pattern is an increase of 100,000. One more. There's no change happening in the hundreds period. There's no change happening with my thousands place. There is a change happening with my 10,000s place and my 100,000s place. This one is particularly difficult to see without putting in a place value chart. Let's see. I already know that I don't have to pay attention to these places because these digits are not changing. Now here I have 505, I have 776. I'm going to add one more number on to my place value chart just to see if it helps. So I have 605482, but I still don't need to worry about these numbers. Okay, so let's see here. What do I have? I notice something. If I look at these numbers together, if I pretend that this is 75, 70, 65, 60, now I see what change is happening. I see that I have a decrease each time, and I see that I am decreasing by something right here. I'm actually decreasing by -5. But since this 5 is in the 10,000s place, that means I'm actually decreasing by 50,000 each time. These digits are not changing. The only digit that's changing in this pattern is my millions digit. I start with 1 million, and then I have 3 million, and then I have 5 million. So I could use a place value chart, or maybe I can see already that I have an increase, and I have an increase of 2 million. So now I need to fill in these blanks in order to make these sentences make sense. So let's see here. Here's my first sentence. 3,345,024 is blank more than 1,345,024. So what was my difference here? 3,345,024 is 2 million more than 1,345,024. So in this blank, I would put 2 million. How about this blank? Yeah, 5,345,024 is blank more than 3,345,024. So let's see, here it is. 5,345,024 is 2 million more than 3,345,024. So once again, I will put 2 million in my blank. Let's see about this one. Blank more than 5,345,024 is blank. So here I need to continue the pattern. 2 million more than 5,345,024 is, well, I just have to add another 2 million to this number, so I will get 7,345,024. So the next number is 7,345,024. All right, let's try that one more time. My hundreds period is not changing. My thousands digit is not changing. I am seeing a change here in my 10,000s digit. And then I'm not seeing a change in my 100,000s digit. So let's see here. I see a 2, I see a 1, I see a 0. So that means my number is decreasing. What is my number decreasing by? Let's see here. I have 2 10,000s and then I have 1 10,000. So I got rid of a 10,000. I have 1 1,000, then I have 0 10,000. So that means that my number is changing by 10,000 each time. So let's see here. 810,346 is blank less than 820,346. So this number is 10,000 less. I just realized that I accidentally wrote 100,000 instead of 10,000. There we go. So this number is 10,000 less than 820,346. 800,000, that should be a 1. 800,346 is 10,000 less than 810,346. So then 10,000 less than 800,346 is, ooh, tricky. So what I need to do is I need to look at this number over here on the side, 800,346. If I'm going to get rid of a 10,000, that means that these numbers are not going to change. However, that means that this number is going to change. Instead of an 8 here, I'm going to have a 7. And then instead of a 0, I'm going to have a 9. So my new number is 790,346. So the next number, 790,346. Whenever we are trying to find the number pattern, there are a couple things to keep in mind. Make sure that you are looking at which digits are changing. Make sure to find out if your pattern is increasing or decreasing, and then you can figure out how much it is increasing or decreasing with each number. You can use a place value chart to help you organize your numbers to see the differences. Because sometimes that difference might be in the middle of the number, and it helps to look at a couple digits together.